In this video, I'm going to show you how to use NotebookLM like a pro so that you can generate a podcast in just a few minutes from any content, be it your own thoughts or some PDF files or a book that you're reading. And I'll show you how you can augment the quality of the content that you generated using InfraNodus, the tool that I developed, that visualizes any file or any knowledge base as a knowledge graph, shows you what are the main topics inside, how they're connected, and what are the gaps within. And I will show you how you can take this information and augment the prompt that you're sending to NotebookLM AI to generate much better content. So for example, when I have it generated, I can add some additional information from the insights I get through InfraNodus to make the quality of the book generation much better. And I will show you how you can do all that and get the results that are truly original, so that you can steer how the conversation is taking place using the insights that you get from the graph that you generated using InfraNodus. So if you're interested to learn how it works, keep watching and I will demonstrate step by step. Also, please subscribe to this channel so that this video gets recommended to other people interested in the same stuff. So let's dive right in. First, I will explain in a little bit more detail how NotebookLM works for those who don't know. Basically, it's a product from Google. You can create any podcast in just a few seconds. So you just click on create new and then you upload some files and it's going to generate the podcast conversation for you. Here I have an example that is hyper realistic and actually really good. Like here is just
Today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. We're going to be exploring.
You see the quality of the voice is quite good. It also gets the content of the book pretty well. So it's a really great thing. And you can then share this conversation or you can download it as an audio file and then put it on your phone and listen to it when you're on the go, for example. So that's really great because if you need to study certain material or you just want to refresh some knowledge, or you could even upload your own notes inside and, you know, you could generate all these insights using this podcast. And it's just a lot of fun playing around with it. The thing is that if you don't control how it generates stuff, it's going to come up with more or less a very general representation of your content. So this is why when you're creating something new, you can customize it here. So if I upload some files, I can then customize how the conversation should happen so that it flows in the direction that I want. And this, I think, is a very interesting thing because that allows you to make it truly original and to really guide how the system should be thinking. But in order for you to know that, you need to know what's inside the content on some kind of high level general overview. And this is what I'm going to show you how you can do that with InfraNodus. So first of all, you will add a new file. So you can add a new file into InfraNodus. Here it's a book that I wrote called Special Agency Manual, Special Agents Manual. And I'm uploading the book. NotebookLM will automatically ingest it into its system and show me a general summary of it. While this is happening, because it's taking some time, I can go into InfraNodus and import this book also. So I will just go to the apps page and then analyze text files, upload the book, leave all the basic settings, InfraNodus special agent, visualize. So it's going to extract the data from that file and the concepts that will be represented as the nodes in the graph and co-occurrences are the connections. And then InfraNodus applies a really powerful set of network analysis algorithms on top of this text to show you what are the main topical clusters inside, how they're related, but most importantly, what are the gaps inside. And the gaps is what we will be using to actually generate some interesting prompts for NotebookLM to guide this conversation in an interesting direction. So for instance, if I get a general overview of this book, I see that it's about agent activation, system procedures. So I'm kind of playing in that book with the idea that it's a manual for the body mind. Like we have manuals for devices. It's the same approach. It's even designed like a manual for a human being. And there are all these topics inside. Agent activation is true. I know this book, so I kind of know that it's like that. System procedure, dynamic control, impulse flow. All right. So these are the four main topics. And then if I go further, I see that we have also agency activation, operating code, impact force, feedback loop. So that's great because almost all the important topics are there. So in fact, what I'm going to do when I see the stuff that I like, I will save them to my project notes because I will later feed them into NotebookLM customize button that we have here. Yeah. So I can add it here and then it will generate a podcast that will be exactly customized with my instructions. But first I'm going to save some ideas into notes. So here I have the main topics, which I kind of agree with. Then I'm going to go into gaps and see if there are any interesting gaps here. So for example, I will highlight some gaps between impulse flow and dynamic control, agency activation, dynamic control. What other ones we have? Impact force, operating code. That's interesting. So I'm gonna ask the underlying AI and InfraNodus to generate a question that could bridge those gaps. So this is the flow. You identify the gap, then you ask a question. And usually it's gonna be a question that connects the two topics that you have in your content that are not yet connected. And this is a great way to develop those ideas further. So here it says, how can the concept of venture fiction, it's one of the concepts I'm talking about in the book, be applied within social networks to foster polysingular outcomes, leveraging the synchronization and harmony of multiple ways of change and innovation to inscribe new realities into collective experience? Amazing question. I'm definitely gonna save it to my notes. So you see it's added into my notes. I just click here, it's saved. I can also just copy and paste it, but I need to generate a few ideas. So I'm gonna do it a few times. And then I will ask it to regenerate some more, see if there is something else original that it comes up with. So here it says into real experiences, including social networks and changing frequencies. So that's kind of similar to what we had before. So we can regenerate the gap and see if there's any other interesting gaps here. For example, between impact force and feedback loop. And you see what's good is that InfraNodus is highlighting for me where I'm actually focusing at the moment. And I can use the graph to kind of explore this in more detail. So here it says, how can the integration of movement and breathing techniques enhance the immersive experience of venture fiction, enabling readers to inscribe fiction into the real through body engagement? So here it's connecting the idea of the body and breathing and how you can embed this idea of venture fiction into body and breathing. That's not something I'm actually connecting in the book. So it's really great because it's forcing me to think about those topics and to develop my own discourse further. So I'm definitely going to save that question again. And then I'm going to generate another one. Maybe here it's going to be between impulse flow and system procedure. Again, I generate a question. By the way, I could also generate an idea, but I like to do the questions more because as a thinker, it's kind of more stimulating to get questions. And also when you feed it back to the AI, especially for the podcast conversation that we're trying to create, this is going to be much more effective because the podcast hosts, the AI hosts, will have to answer those questions. So this is why it's so nice to do it like this. Then I will save it also into notes. Here it's talking about how can the principles of venture fiction and body-mind operating systems be integrated into somatocognitive infrastructure to enhance the resilience and adaptability of networks in the face of systemic tension and incoming change? Amazing. I really like the stuff that it's generating. It's not surprising that I like it because it finds the topics that are not connected yet and generates questions that would potentially connect them. And this is why it's always like a little Eureka moment, because it's always really great ideas that it comes up with, because it's the things I thought about. Like, I definitely wrote about impulse flows and system procedures, but I didn't write about them in the same context. And when you ask me a question, oh, but how does this relate to that? It's like, oh yeah, sure. Like, I should have thought about this before, but I haven't. So this is why you will see when you use it yourself with InfraNodus, you will have a lot of fun generating those questions. So I'm just going to generate a few more and then see if there are any other gaps. By the way, I can also do it manually, so I don't have to use this function. I can just go into the main ideas and maybe just look at the topics that I think should be connected. For instance, let's say I want to see impulse flow and impact response. And then I can, if I select them both, I can also generate a question here in the AI message pad here. And then, you know, you can just use the graph a few times to find the topics that would be on the opposite sides of the graph. So you can even use this visual representation to see what you should be connecting, which can be especially useful if you don't know the content so well, because if they are on the opposite sides of the graph, because of the way the alignment works, it uses force atlas layout, so it pushes the clusters of ideas that are not connected in this particular text away from each other. So that gives you a really nice visual representation of the things that could be better connected, because here, for instance, stability dynamics, agent interaction, not so well connected in my text, only through movement, right? I see that there is a mutual connector here, maybe also use and practice, but not so much stuff. So this is great because then I can click on this AI mode here and ask it to generate another question that would link those topics in an interesting way. So let's say I generated a few questions. I have also those main topics here, right? What I can also do, by the way, is add some of those terms here, blind spots, conceptual gateways. So this kind of thing I really like because they highlight the terms that are the entrance points into this discourse. It's like, I like to make this analogy with social networks when I analyze text networks. You always want to approach people who know the most important people, but who don't have so many connections, so they're not overwhelmed with the amount of information that's flowing through them. And this is exactly what those conceptual gateways are. So they can be very useful whether you want to get into this discourse or if you want to connect this discourse to other discourses. So I like to add this because it's kind of like the parts of the text which could enable me to connect these ideas to the outside world. And I'm going to save them also, and you see there will be listed here separately. So now it's time to feed this back into the NotebookLM. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to this page that we're creating for my book. I will click customize and then I will add some custom instructions. If you use the AI stuff, it's like custom prompt basically. And first I will say that, okay, I will copy this stuff here. So these are the structural insights from InfraNodus on my original file, and I will say make sure you focus on those in your conversation, and then I paste this stuff. Oh, by the way, it cannot be too long, so this is why I will have to cut it a little bit. So this is one little problem with NotebookLM, but you have open source versions of it where you will not have this limit. I think I'm going to make another video explaining how they work. But for instance, now I will have to be really concise in my instruction, and I will have to choose one question out of the many amazing ones I have. Okay, this is great. And then let's add one question also that we like. So for instance, from all of these, I think I'm going to choose this one with the body and adaptability and the physical movement into immersive experience, adventure fiction. Okay, great. So then I click generate. You see I have my question that I generated and the topics, and then I click generate. The good thing about NotebookLM is that you can actually generate a few podcasts. So maybe I use this question to generate this one and then another question to generate another one. And I hope in the future they will also extend this context window. What you can also do, and I will make another video on that later, is that you could actually export this as a text file, so you can save this as a text file. Okay, this will be my notes, all saved, and then you could add it as a source. And once you add it as a source, then you can generate a new file, but you would need to specify in the prompt that you need to use that file. So that would be kind of like a slightly more pro way of doing that with a few more iterations. But this is how you do it. If you really want all of this to make its way in, you would download that file, add it here, and then add in the customization note that you wanted to focus on that particular file. And you want the conversation to be circling around those ideas and also the questions in that file. So you can even name it questions and then refer to it in the prompt. And then it's going to try to kind of guide itself into this direction. And then while it's generating the podcast, you can actually also get some insights on the actual file. So you can have it generate like a study guide for you of the book, or the briefing doc, which enables you to kind of get like a high level overview of what's inside FAQ section, timeline, and so on. But also you can do all this with InfraNodus with your original graph, because this is basically what it's doing. It's giving you this kind of high level overview of the main ideas, and then allows you to see how they all relate to one another and what's missing inside. And one thing that you can also do in InfraNodus that's very useful is that you can remove some of the surface layer nodes. Like for instance, if you want to get to the depth of the content, you would remove this top layer, body, order, action, maybe special also. And then once you do that, you get to the part that is much more specific, and you get much more specific topics from it. So you could even export those topics again and then add them to your original prompt so that you can generate a conversation that's much more specific. So this is how you could do it also in a few iterations. Like the first approach is to get a high level idea, then you slice off the top layer of concepts. It recalculates everything, shows you the new topics which are hiding underneath, and then you add them to the conversation. And once you're done, then it generates a podcast for you, which will be touching upon those latent topics as well. So this is how it works. Try it out with InfraNodus to analyze your underlying files, and with NotebookLM. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments to this video. And also please subscribe to the channel so that it can get recommended to other people interested in this content, and let me know your feedback about this whole experience. Thank you.